And so let me conclude with another question. What advice do you have for students that are taking this course and learning parallel programming maybe for the first time?
I think parallel programming requires you to think about your program in a different way. And the thing that I see most when I go out and I spend a lot of my time talking to people who are trying to use not just GPUs, but clustered computer systems and multi-core systems and everything. I spend a lot of my job is finding out the problems people are facing. A lot of the problems boil down to not MPI is hard or clusters is hard or networking is hard. It actually boils down to parallel programming is hard. And it's hard because a lot of them are thinking in terms of, I know how to write a serial program. I assume parallel programming must be the same. But often you need to think about your problem in a different way. You need to think about how do I break my problem up into independent pieces? Because the way that you get your parallel problem solved is to have lots of independent pieces which only come together either in small subsets or infrequently. Because Amdahl's law will always kill you in the end. And so you've got to find a way around that. And if you start out thinking of your problem in parallel terms instead of in serial terms, you will end up with a much better solution to your problem. It's sort of analogous to how if you're trying to solve a problem in C++, maybe this doesn't actually apply to the people listening to this, I'm not sure. If you're trying to solve your problem in C++, don't start thinking about it in C. Because although you can express C in C++, your solution in C++ will be a very different design to how you'd have solved it in C. Same goes for parallel serial programming. So this is not just CUDA advice in general, this is parallel programming advice in general. Sit down and think about your problem in terms of where can I extract the independent work, rather than how do I do the work, now how do I multiply it by 10.
Stephen, thanks so much for coming in today. We appreciate your time.
It's a pleasure.